Catch grubs. Cut off.
Donayre against Banario is brought to you by Patron, fuel for everyone.
Ready, go!
Banario, who dominated the featherweights at one time, now in the lightweight division.
Yeah, Donayre has been asking this for this fight since these two both fought in URCC, and he finally gets his wish here in Manila tonight. Both fighters light on their feet.
Big high guard that Honorio has.
Banario's just got nice, tight, crisp boxing. We've seen that in a lot of his past fights. He loves to throw the hands, and he throws them with vicious intent.
Right
hand, Steve. I don't know if the spawn is fully recovered.
That's the kind of power he can exhibit. That's the kind of power that put Oishi down several times. But Donayre comes back with left hands. Oh, the two of them miss with absolutely huge swinging rights. They both ducked under them. Tremendous action here in the first minute and a quarter.
They realize this is their opportunity and they're taking advantage of it. And these two throw down in the middle of the cage.
It's not worth blinking, is it? Because anything can happen at any minute. These two are just throwing bombs. And you start to understand why Banario has such a high guard.
Yeah, but that also leaves his body exposed to a lot of shots. So he's got to be careful, keep those elbows nice and tight so the spawn doesn't unload some of those body kicks and body shots that can just drain you.
Oh, another big right hand from Banario. And again, it was as Donayre came in.
I do not know how many of those Donayre can eat, because those are huge shots landing on the left side of his head. Slides into kind of a half guard there. He's popping that leg out, trying to work the side control. There's an attempt at a technical head kick there. Ooh, big shot.
Whenever Donayre comes in so far, he's either been caught by a big punch or moved into a takedown position. So he's got to watch his attack, because Banario is countering them with expert ability.
Donario's got that closed guard, which just kind of locks Banario into position there. You really got to open up your guard and create kind of some movement. He's attempting possibly a Kimura there. He's trying to use that cage now to sort of get over onto his side and possibly work his way back up to his feet.
On the right of your screen, Mark Sangio, head of Team Lakai, shouting out instructions. That's Edward Folayong in the pale blue t-shirt, just guiding Banario through his every move. They're just 3 feet away from him.
See, I like how he spun him around. You know, that could have been what Mark was saying. I don't know, because my Tagalog is not that good, but he spun him around and kept his back away from the fence. And when your back's against the fence, you can possibly use it to get back up. But you can see Banario spun him around, and now he doesn't have that option. So he can just work the ground and pound from here.
Donayre was looking to unload that elbow on Bonario's head, and he managed to get one or two in there.
Donayre pops back up.
The crowd are delighted to see them back on their feet, Mitch.
Oh, these guys are throwing. We got less than 1 minute here in the first round.
Donayre has to be careful as he comes in. That's where he's been punished each time. 40 seconds left to the first.
Nice little leg kick there. Landed to that shin knee area, which can really hurt. Donayre looks to be slowing down just a little bit.
Spinning back fist, didn't have much power behind it. It has that element of surprise sometimes if you can spin quickly enough.
Donayre light. likes the spinning attacks. He likes to throw the back elbows, the spinning back fists. He's looking up at the clock now, just seeing kind of where this ends as the 10-second clicker goes off.
Elbow, super little shot from Bonario as we hit the end of this first round, and it's been tremendous entertainment. Furious action from start to finish.
Yeah, good first round for Bonario there as he landed that takedown, just kind of ended. There's that big right hand by Bonario. He attempted the kick. Donayre's coming back, and there's another one. He just waits and throws it right over the top, and then they're just swinging for the fences there as Bonario lands the takedown and ends up in top position. There's a nice little short elbow. Let's go to Rich Franklin now and kind of see how he has it so far.
I think you said it best, Mitch. This was a great first round for Bonario. Both these guys came out very aggressive. They were at the beginning of the round, Donayre was landing some strikes, doing a little bit of effective striking, but Bonario basically ran away with the striking, earned the takedowns, controlled on the ground, did a little ground and pound there. And so at this point, if the fight was stopped at the 5-minute mark, he would definitely be ahead on the scorecards.
Those categories there that you see on the screen that Rich took us through, the items at the top carry more weight than the items at the bottom. So keep that in mind next time you look at that graphic that we throw up to show you how Rich is seeing the fight. Oh, right uppercut thrown by Bonario that missed by a whisker. May even have caught a whisker. Oh, and he got rocked there, the Team Lakai fighter, as Donayre shows that he has power too. Brings his opponent to the ground.
Attempted the choke there, but ended up in a bad position as he's on his back again. Looked like Donayre was offering him a hand to get back up, but I think he was just kind of protecting the feet there.
I wouldn't be surprised if he backs off at this stage just to take it to its feet again.
Donayre wants this on the ground. He's like, come get it. Well, Yuji wants him up.
Yeah, it's Yuji who took the decision in the end. Good. Still that high guard of Bonario, and Donayre slightly more relaxed with his hands. Left and right from Bonario, and Donayre goes back. He takes more punishment to the head, moves to the side to try and evade Bonario's attack. Throwing with wild abandon, Bonario now.
Bonario sneaks in after that vicious exchange there, and he sinks in this single leg, and now he's just back into guard. But wow, these guys are throwing with some bad intentions. They're just dropping their head and throwing. If anybody gets caught, their head's popping off. Those are huge punches.
When he throws Bonario, he really lets go, doesn't he?
And they're just missing by just a fraction of a centimeter. They're so close, you can almost feel the wind coming off those punches.
Has been one of the most entertaining fighters that ONE Championship has had the pleasure of inviting to its cage.
I understand the importance of the ground game, but I want to see these two throw again.
This is Bonario's 9th time in a ONE Championship cage.
See Donayre, he's trying to work to the cage. He's trying to get back up, but I think he's just using this time to just kind of catch his breath. He's not really taking a lot of damage here, you know, on the ground, so he can just kind of wait, bide his time, take some big, deep breaths, and just let everything settle back down. You can see him just kind of holding on there.
Action!
You know, when you hold somebody like that, it does take a little bit of energy, but you're also using your feet. You can see from the closed guard and that left hand wrapped around his head that it's really not that big of an energy expenditure because your legs are doing a lot of the work. And Bonario is kind of obliging by keeping his head planted in his chest. Donayre is trying to use that arm and shrimp out to the side where he kind of pops his hips out to create something from happening. But Bonario has just got really good pressure. He's just controlling this fight really well when he's in the top position.
Using his head there just to shape himself up against Donayre's body.
Donayre could get up right here. He could just push off the head because his head's low and he could just slide up. But Bonario spins him around and puts him back down on his back.
It's the elbows that Donayre is looking to land, but Bonario gives himself a little bit of room so that he can throw some punches.
Oh, throws his legs up, possible submission there. Could have been an arm bar. And Bernario throws the legs off and ends up in sort of a mount north-south position. Donayre goes after the single leg here. He's trying to suck that leg in and maybe turn the corner. But Bernario's going to use it to stand back up. Sprawls out and takes his back. Good ground control there by Bernario, and he's in a bad position to punch. What's he doing? Armbar, setting something up.
He's reaching in for something, isn't he?
He's looking for it.
Yeah.
He's looking. He's trying. Armbar.
Speak here at Cage Side. This crowd is going absolutely wild.
Oh, look at Donayre. Look at him spinning again.
Well, these two are absolutely loving it, as indeed is everybody else in this arena. Donayre breathing hard, though.
Oh, yeah, Steve. I think he is exhausted right now, waiting for the clicker, the 10-second one. How conditioned are these two fighters? Right now, they're going to get 1 minute to recompose themselves and then go to war again.
I think that 1 minute can't come quickly enough for Donayre. A tremendous exhibition of entertaining combat sports.
Oh, man, look at this. There's that. Oh. Donayre landed one, and then Bernario answered right back, and then just unloads in a nice exchange here that brought the crowd to their feet. And then drops the head and just starts winging before he secured the single leg. Rich Franklin, what is it so far?
I'll tell you, every time these guys start throwing punches, you never know what's going to happen. But each time they're exchanging and they're trading, Bernario is just edging it out a little more and a little more. On the ground there, I was actually quite impressed with the armbar escape that Donayre had there. But still, he's increased his leads in basically all the categories, earned himself another takedown, and at this point in time, if the fight was stopped, it would be Bernario.
Well, let's hope the fight isn't stopped because it's so entertaining. Oh. Another 5 minutes, yes, please.
This is right here where champions are made. When you have to go in to the third round, your body is telling you to quit, but your mind just believes you can do it. These two are getting ready to throw down for the final 5 minutes. Here we go.
Great sportsmanship between the two. I don't think I've heard this crowd quite as noisy as they were in that last round, and they make some noise here traditionally.
With very good reason. By Bernario as he goes up to the head and then down to the body.
I wonder if this is where perhaps cardio will start to tell. Donayre was tired towards the end of that last round. He's breathing a little bit open-mouthed here. And don't forget, Bernario trains in the hills at high altitude. Cardio is his thing.
Oh, yeah, Bernario has been, you know, into the deep rounds. He's fought into the championship rounds. He went to round four there at Kelly. Cardio is never a problem for any member of Team Lakai. Oh, cut the kick and brought him down.
Thunderous noise as Donayre's back slammed against the canvas.
Another big takedown by Bernario. Let's see what Donayre can do. He's got to create something off his back right here. Because typically he's been here for a couple of minutes, you know, so he's got to create some movement. He's doing his best work on his feet. He's got to get back up to his feet. He's got to create movement. He's got to at least threaten some submission, Steve. He's got to be looking to attack.
Come to finish, boss.
Well, he did come up with that armbar attempt in the second round.
He's trying to move out to the side, but Bernario's just got so much strength. He's such a strong fighter. All these Team Lakai fighters are so strong. But Bernario's just shutting his submission game down. You know, he's burying his head right next to his. He's not letting him, you know, you can see Donaire's trying to think about throwing the legs up for a submission, but Bonario's just shutting it down by keeping himself so tight and so close. But the downside of that is he's not able to strike as much as he should. You see, he's just landing these little pitter-pat little shots. That's not gonna do damage. That's not gonna hurt. It's gonna be annoying, but it's winning him little bit incremental improvements.
You can see that Donayre is marked around the left eye and down the side of his face there, but no cuts. That's not going to bother him, not with 2.5 minutes left of this contest. Yuji Shimada stands them up so that this crowd get to see a little bit more of the incredible striking entertainment that we've had in this contest so far. And a right hand from Bonario signals the beginning of that. He just looks the fresher of the two of them standing up, and he comes forward with a leaping right hand that pushed Donayre back into the cage. And I just wonder if with 2 minutes left, Donayre's slightly lower held hands and the signs that he might be slightly more fatigued means that he's going to get caught with one of these crisp, heavy blows from Bonario that could just end it. It would be a shame for Donayre, that's for sure.
And Bonario's putting together some good combinations. You know, he's moving really well. He's attacking the body. He's going back up to the head. But I don't think he can finish the fight here. You know, he's not really working to pass the guard. You know, he's happy just to stay in the half guard or the full guard of Donayre and just sort of unleash these little bits of ground and pound that he's doing.
75 seconds left.
Donayre pops back up. 1 minute, 1 minute. Now he's got 1 minute. He glances up at it. He's got to turn on the juice right here. If he can throw it into a high level, Donayre's hands are coming down by his stomach.
10 years between these two. Donayre is 36 years old, and he's done so well to get this far and stay competitive against the younger man, the former world champion. Looks as if there was a groin shot there that bothers Bonario. Rich Franklin, the deal here is that he'll get around 5 minutes.
Yeah, he gets the duration of a round to make sure he's okay. This was very incidental. He doesn't look very injured. So I would imagine that Bonario is just going to shake this off and come back to the fight.
Yuji Shimada's beckoning him to go over to one corner of the cage, which I suppose is a neutral corner.
But he's also giving Donayre a little bit more juice left. You know, when he was starting to fatigue, he started to tire. You can see his hands on his legs. You can see him heavy breathing. But Ario's got to jump back in there and get it going again.
Because if Donaire's going to win this, he's going to have to do something pretty special in the moments that remain. And that little bit of breathing space that he's had may help him to do that.
You can see that leg come up in just super slow motion.
It's a good right hand from Bonario.
When your body starts to shut down and you start to get fatigued, it's like you're throwing punches and kicks in deep water. Everything moves so slow.
Again, the trouble for Donayre comes when he moves forward and gets caught on the counter. But there, he executed very well.
Nice.
We will
flurry.
Get to the end of this contest. The wood has been smacked together to signal final 10 seconds. Yuji Shimada weighs in with some of the punishment. And this crowd will be on their feet applauding compatriots that have given them tremendous entertainment for 15 minutes. And this is the kind of thing that you see very often in martial arts, mixed martial arts, both fighters on their knees, paying respect to each other, arm in arm, smiling at each other. That's so good to see.
Yeah, there's another one of those big shots landed by Bonario as he was moving forward. Both these fighters just rushing forward, throwing hands, no caution at all, just throwing caution to the wind as they push forward. There's that nice little short elbow landed by Bonario. Overall, great fight. Rich, what do you have so far? How did you see this fight?
This is, I'll tell you, the third round, Bonario just continued to edge things out basically in each category. Earned some more takedowns. Continued his increasing his lead on his striking superiority. So this goes to the judges' scorecard. No doubt in my mind that Bonario is going to have this unanimous decision.
And if indeed that is the result, it will be so good to see him back to winning ways because he's a tremendously entertaining fighter, and at 26 still has so much to offer. Here's Anthony Suntai.
Ladies and gentlemen, after three rounds, we go to the judges' scorecards. And all three judges, see it for your winner via unanimous decision. From the red corner, Honorio The Rock Banario!